question about it one way or the other. Neither a question of law nor a question of fact, that whatever Miss Anthony's intentions may have been, she did not have a right to vote, and if she did vote without having a lawful right to vote, then there is no question but what she is guilty of violating the law of the United States.
Mr. Sheldon, you may proceed with the opening statement for the defense.
If the court please, and gentlemen of the jury, this is a case of no ordinary magnitude. The question is whether my client has done anything to justify her being consigned to a felon's prison. When she offered to have her name registered as a voter, and when she offered her vote, she was as much entitled to vote as any man that voted in that election. She has committed no offense and is entitled to be discharged at your hands. But beyond that, whether she was entitled to vote or not, if she sincerely believed that she had a right to vote and offered her ballot in good faith, under that belief, she is guilty of no crime. Before the registration, before this election, Miss Anthony called upon me for advice upon the question of whether, under the 14th Amendment of the Constitution of the United States, she had a right to vote. And I advised her that she was as lawful a voter as I, or as any other man is, and advised her to go and offer her vote. She acted in the most perfect good faith, and if she made a mistake, or if I made one, that is not a reason for committing her to a felon's cell.
Mr. Prosecutor, call your first witness.
I call Mr. Beverly W. Jones.
Do you swear on this Bible that you will tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Mr. Jones, upon the 5th day of November, did the defendant, Susan B. Anthony, vote in the first election district of the 8th Ward of the City of Rochester?
Yes, sir.
Did you see her vote?
Yes, sir.
Was Miss Anthony challenged upon that occasion?
Yes, sir. No. Not on that day she wasn't.
She was not challenged on the day she voted?
No, sir.
I pass the witness.
Now, part of the election, was there a registry of voters in that district made?
Yes, sir.
Were you one of the officers engaged in making that registry, sir?
Yes, sir.
When the registry was being made, did Miss Anthony appear before the Board of Registry and claim to be registered as a voter?
She did.
Was there any objection made or any doubt raised as to her right to vote?
There was.
On what ground, sir?
On the ground that the Constitution of the State of New York did not allow women to vote.
And what was the defect that in her right to vote as a citizen?
She was not a male citizen.
That she was a woman?
Yes, sir.
Now, did the board consider that and decide that she was entitled to register?
Objection.
Overruled.
Did the board consider the question of her right to register and decide that she was entitled to register as a voter?
Yes, sir.
And she was registered accordingly?
Yes, sir.
When she offered a vote, was the same objection brought up before the board of inspectors, or was any question made of her right to vote as a woman?
She was challenged previous to election day.
She was challenged previous to election day between them.
Yes, sir. She was challenged on the 2nd day of registering names.
At the time of the registry, when her name was registered, was the supervisor of election present at the board?
He was.
Was he consulted upon the question of whether she was entitled to registry, or did he express an opinion on that subject to the inspectors?
I submit that it is no consequence whether he did or not.
He was the government supervisor under this set of Congress.
The Board inspectors under state law can constitute the Board of Registry, and they are the only persons to pass upon the question.
You may answer.
Yes, sir. There was a United States Supervisor of Elections, two of them.
Did they advise the registry or did they not?
One of them did.
And on that advice, registry was made with the judgment of the inspectors.
It had a great deal of weight with the inspectors, I have no doubt.
I pass the witness, Your Honor.
Was Ms. Anthony challenged before the Board of Registry?
Not at the time she offered her name.
Was she challenged at any time?
Yes, sir. The second day of the meeting of the board.
Was a preliminary and a general oath administered?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you state what Ms. Anthony said, if she said anything, when she came here and offered her name for registration?
She stated that she did not claim any right under the Constitution of the State of New York. She claimed her right under the Constitution of the United States.
Did she name any particular amendment?
Yes, sir. She signed the 14th Amendment.
Under that, she claimed the right to vote.
Yes, sir.
Did the other federal supervisor who was present state it as his opinion that she was entitled to vote under that amendment? Or did he protest, claiming that she did not have the right to vote?
One of them said that there was no way for the inspectors to get around placing the name upon the register. The other one, when she came in, left the room.
Did the one who said there was no way to get around placing the name on the register say that she had the right to register, but did not have the right to vote?
I didn't hear him make any such statement.
You didn't hear him make any such statement as that?
No, sir.
Was there a poll list kept for the voters for the first selection district of the 8th Ward on the day of election?
Yes, sir.
State whether that is the poll list of voters kept upon the day of election in the first district of the 8th Ward of the city of Rochester.
This is the poll list and also the register.
Please start with the name of Susan B. Anthony, if it is upon that list.
I have it.
What number is it?
Number 22.
From the poll list, what tickets does it report to show that she voted upon that occasion?
Electoral, state, Congress, and assembly.
The prosecution rests.
The witness is excused.